All right. I've been doing YouTube a really long time. Different channels over the years. And I started in the period of time where, you know, you would troll each other, you would do certain things to sort of get certain reactions, you know, bait some traps, right? And it was great too, because we had a lot of, you know, good times with video responses and stuff like that. But sometimes people think they get one over you. So this guy did a video. He did a video because he said that I faked my trophy platinum for Mortal Kombat 9, which was one of the hardest to get, and did a video that is now deleted. Oh, well, you don't have any proof. Actually, I do have proof, because the proof of the video existing is in my Chrome Google history. Oh, what's that? Fight all thy enemies, PS3 trophies exposed, he's a liar. It's deleted. You can see the other videos there that I used to do my clip, the Ed Boon firing everyone. I actually had somebody's comment was like, is this clickbait? No, it's a joke. This comedy is lost on people. Anyway, you can see the video existing right there. In response to this, because he's been sitting there going, oh, you didn't know how to do, find out about smoke in MK9. Okay. I don't remember everything, but that's okay. Because regardless, I did it. I probably don't remember half the fatalities in MK3, but I would have at the time. That's okay. I don't just sit there and read fatalities every day to keep my memory fresh and have a life. There's a reason why I didn't show my PSN. Two reasons, actually. The first one is, well, people love to go out of their way to try and dox people, find stuff out about others, because, well, their life is shit. And they have made up a predetermination of who you are and your character because you said something about a video game. And I like that video game, isn't it something terrible? That's the first reason I didn't show it, right? Not that you'd find much. But the second reason is, well, as I've been explaining to people in my Discord, in chat, that when I do a video, and if you're somehow confused by it, by all means, hit me up on Discord and ask me about it. Because sometimes it's going to seem like I don't know what I'm doing. What is the purpose? What are you doing here? The purpose is very simple. I didn't realize how far over the target I was until I was over the target. See, as an old school YouTuber, we know how to bait traps. We know how to get people to react on certain things. But one thing you won't find with me on this channel is me lying. I don't lie. I don't need to lie. Perfectly happy with my life. I've got no reason to lie to make myself look great. I certainly could have lied when I was asked by Diddle whether or not I knew what Uplock was and quickly Google searched it on the side so that way when he asked, I could have gone, oh, that's it. No, because I was being honest. I also said that I had done it in the tutorial, which I then proved later on to Foxy. And these people are so bent out of shape. I'm hearing other reports of other people just, well, they're mad. And why are they mad? Why is that? Because they've been trying to get away with something for so long? Thinking that, you know, people haven't been catching on to the way they do things for a really long time? Oh, you give people names and make fun of them. Is Condiment Twins gonna put you in therapy? Sloppy Seconds gonna put you in therapy? Okay. A lot of these people don't exactly behave in the most wonderful ways, but then being leftists, I'm not really shocked by that whatsoever. But there's an old saying, it's, you know, what's good for the goose is good for the gander. But don't worry, I actually have even more proof right here.
All right. So, this is, in case any of you young people out there don't remember, is a PS3. Right. I did a video talking about my trophies that I platinumed both Mortal Kombat Complete Edition, or the original Mortal Kombat when it first came out, which was a US copy, and of course the Mortal Kombat Arcade Collection. And there's a certain individual that decided to try and prove me wrong because they found my username, this one, which as you can see doesn't have very many trophies whatsoever at all, as proof. And he's correct. I didn't platinum this game on this one. I platinumed it on the first account I ever made, which was this one. Oh, what was that? Oh, you thought you had me? Oh, okay, my bad. Well, here we go. Logging in. Not too slow, actually, considering. Okay. Now, we come across. Oh, is that me? Oh, that's a shame. 293 trophies. There's my other account. I even have an account for the UK as well, my Asian one, if you're more than happy to have a look at that. And all these people, my old friends list. And now when we compare it to my actual trophy video, you'll see that this matches up exactly with the amount of trophies as well as the icon. The reason why in the original video I didn't show my username is for exactly what this guy did. Decided to go searching on the internet, thinking that he knew everything, and he failed.
I can see clearly now, the rain has gone. I can see all the obstacles in my way. I can see clearly now, the rain has gone. Gone are the dark, dark clouds that have me blind. Ooh. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. It's gonna be a bright shiny day. I had the lyrics over here, by the way. It's fantastic. Thank you, Jimmy Cliff, putting out a wonderful song that I absolutely butchered. You know what's funny? These people will never get me. You'll never get me. You want to know why? Because I don't lie. I don't lie and I don't steal, I don't deceive. And it seems very much that I'm over the target when it comes to this community because I'm so small and so insignificant that somehow I'm living rent-free, mortgage-free. These people are paying for my kids' tuition. You know, next week I'm going to be able to start Ubering food to my house. They are literally paying me. Right. And why is that? Why do you think that is? There's a lot of people out there that say the same thing that I do. I'm not any different. I'm not any unique individual. But I think it's the fact that, well, you know, you can't really do much to me. Right? I'm simply just talking about a video game. Wanting Mortal Kombat to be the greatest fighting game franchise of all time. And I'm really sick and tired of seeing its bastardization happening continually. You don't like those videos talking negative? Well, I don't like talking about them either. But sometimes you need to get things changed and or at least hope that things can be changed. And we know most of the only pros don't actually care about the health of the entire game of Mortal Kombat. They only care about themselves. We know the shills and the sellouts and the con artists out there. They don't care about the health of the game or what they can just simply get out of it. You know, everything from their little clickbait titles to deleting certain videos to hide evidence. Well, I pay attention, I've been paying attention for a really long time, and I've been in that particular frame of mode since the early days when I started doing my YouTube stuff. Because I realized that people will try and can do anything to get one up on you, to try and prove you wrong or whatnot. Now, we know the only pros are mad because, well, oh, you know, they say you don't know Upblock. Well, I've memed Upblock so hard that I own it now. It's mine. It's my meme. Right? I've got people in my live streams, on my comments, absolutely loving it. You have no power here. Because you don't understand. And that's why you will never understand. The shills and the sellouts out there, that will never understand. Because what they see is something for themselves. They don't care about the well-being of the actual community. The community for Mortal Kombat is shit. And I see a lot of people out there very saddened by what is going on and the state of things. You know. And that's a shame. Now, I will admit, the only thing I actually got wrong in this video is because I said I had, was it, 293 trophies. That's incorrect. Obviously, it's my level. But since I haven't played on a PlayStation since what? When was the last time I played on a PlayStation? Maybe 2016, I'd have to check. When was the last game that I actually played? Like officially played until I got it back. Right, because I got a PS3, right? My daughter plays on it. You know, she plays on it with her friends. That's why these games here that you can see. Let me just move this video down. All right, hang on. You can see these games at the top here. All right, here's a little kids game. She plays with her friends. Minecraft, Digger, Crazy Taxi, Little Big Planet 2, Order Up, Frogger, Fat Princess. Great game, by the way. Hamster Ball. And then when I actually got rid of my first PlayStation and came back to PC, which is when I had the Vita, I also got rid of that at the same time at EB Games. Traded in all my 400 plus physical copied games. That's why I have on here, I played 802 games. Because I had about half of that in digital, half of that in physical, and I sold the physical to EB Games. You get 20% trade-in discount on top, and because you can actually keep the money from when you do a trade-in, at least here in Australia, I probably walked away with about $4,000, which I heavily invested back into PC gaming. For those wondering why I have over 8,000 games on Steam, well, I shop smart, but that's the massive contributor to it. So the last time I actually properly played something would have been in the year of 2014, right? Yeah, and then of course, in 2018, when I got a secondhand PS3 back, my daughter plays on it. Whoa. Yes. I know it's hard. I know you thought you had me. I know some of you out there think you had me. But see, I don't watch those videos. So you can keep making them. It's fantastic. It just drives traffic. For the people out there that think this is a grift and this is all an act, no, I'm being genuine. But I also know what threads to pull. Because the threads are leading to the truth. And the truth is that I see a bunch in this community that don't give a shit about anything about the actual fighting game community for Mortal Kombat. And I see a lot of people out there that are starving for that old community to come back. Where we were in one, just like how we see with Tekken, just like how we see with Street Fighter and other fighting game communities out there. Mortal Kombat is so and absolutely abominably just like fractured that it's sad. We should all be on the same page. But when it's very clear that there's people out there that really only give a shit about what they can get out of it and don't actually care whether or not the game is successful, whether the game itself actually has a lot of stuff for everyone. Yeah. I'm gonna grab that fucking thread. I'm gonna pull on that shit like a bungee cord. And I've been doing that a really long time. I can't stand people that lie and con and deceive. It's who I am. I hate it. You can thank God for that, because without my faith, I wouldn't be able to have the strength to be able to sit here and say, no, I'm calling out the bullshit. Now, I can be wrong, and that's fine. But what you won't be right about is me being a liar. So maybe next time, guys, why don't you come have a chat with me? I have a Discord. Come have a chat. Got a problem? I'm happy to have a talk to you. And actually, I do have people that have joined the Discord server, asked to have a chat to me to get my perspective. I've had people in the comment sections asked to have a chat with me, ask my perspective. I had someone go, oh, well, if I like doing combos, am I a only pro? I said, do you care about the welfare of the entire product of Mortal Kombat? And they're like, yes. I said, that's okay. You're not an only pro. See, these people know who they are. That's why they're reacting the way they are, which is fantastic considering that I'm meaningless. As Sloppy Seconds said, you're not going to change anything. What a wonderful attitude to have. What a wonderful attitude to have. I'll tell you what though, prominent figure in history, goes by the name of Jesus, right? And I'm not saying I'm that. It's just an example of how so many people thought he was wrong. So many people, you know, deceived him and, you know, eventually ended up taking his life. And not once did he stray from his path, the truth. And I advise and encourage everyone out there to do the same for whatever it is in life, whether it's about standing beside a principle when it comes to consumer products or standing beside a principle in life, you know, in some serious shit going on. You fortify that morality and nobody can puncture it. And everyone thought Jesus was wrong until the quakes hit. And the temples were destroyed. And everyone suddenly realized that this whole time that he was correct. And that is a wonderful inspiration for me. To, despite any flack that I get, to stay true to myself, as you guys should stay true to yourselves. I'm just me. I'm not special. At all. I'm just me. And I want a lot of these other guys that may or may not have smaller channels than me to keep rising, to keep getting bigger. Because I want us all to make this community great again, because we all love Mortal Kombat for a variety of reasons. But it depends whether or not you're going to be one of them, or you're going to join the rest of us. Because this is not how it used to be. And I've been around long enough to know that. Some of you young guys haven't, but I'm telling you, it was better. And there are various factors for that, naturally, that I've talked about. But ultimately, at the end of the day, we all want Mortal Kombat to be a wonderful game. We don't want to feel like we're being ripped off. We want to feel like it's a good and balanced game to have fun with our friends or online. And we want to feel like there's tons to do, that it furthers the Mortal Kombat story forward. That we get excited about the storylines and whatnot. That's Mortal Kombat. Oh boy. I do hope somebody tries a little bit harder than this one. Well, actually I don't. It's a bit aggravating, but just saying. Not the best attempt.